My name's John Warford. I am 45. I'm from Maui, Hawaii. I flew here yesterday in hopes that Dr. Lee can save me from my side boob. It's got some girth. I can shimmy it, I can bounce it. It's definitely a boob. It tapers to a point. It deserves a nipple. Aloha, I'm John Warford. I have an appointment with Dr. Lee. This boob has become a burden over the last 20 years. It has grown quite a bit in the last 5 years.
We are gonna be all the way down this hall.
It has affected my self-esteem to some extent.
Have a seat right up here, and Dr. Lee is gonna be in just a few minutes.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
If Dr. Lee's able to remove my boob, I will be able to go to the beach more and not have to scold my friends when they won't look me in the eyes because my boob is hanging out.
Hi.
Hello, Dr. Lee.
How are you?
My goodness, you're so pretty. It's so nice to meet you.
Oh, nice to meet you too.
Oh, yes,
well,
thank
hello.
You for
you're
seeing
Mr.
me.
Warford, right?
I am.
John?
I've been joking that I've come for my boob job.
Oh, I don't do boob jobs, so let's see what's going
on
here.
It's a reverse boob job.
Well, where is this area? Oh, I see.
A C, exactly.
Okay,
it's a C cup. Right.
I do make the joke that lipomas look like boobs, but this one looks like a boob.
Okay, may I touch your
Please.
Boob here? Okay. I see that. I see how it's like even dimpled at the end like that, like a little nipple,
there
huh?
There seems to be a passage right in the middle of that, too.
Okay, you can kind of dip your finger in there?
Yeah.
It's almost like you have like a little stretch mark there, almost.
Yeah. It's been there since 98.
98, okay.
But it was about a third of the size until I turned 40. Post 40, it's grown the most because of my little bit of body fat and
got
a little
it.
Bit of alcohol.
You feel like it really kind of went a little fast. Oh, so you're blaming it on your body fat, on eating a little too much and alcohol, huh?
I never eat too much. I'm only 150
pounds. You look like you're pretty, yes.
But I started drinking a little bit,
okay.
And I think that added to it for
sure. And it doesn't cause you pain or anything like that?
No,
like I said,
doesn't.
It just slowly moves around and just slowly growing.
Yes.
Okay.
I am nervous and excited and scared.
It makes you nervous about removing it, or it makes you nervous about what it is? Are you not nervous at all about that?
I haven't seen a doctor in 25 years.
Wow, okay.
So lab work in context to it might reveal things that I don't want to know.
Okay.
John, being such a skinny guy, it is really noticeable. Any collection of fat that you have right under your skin is going to look a lot like a boob because it's going to hang like that. I mean, that's what a boob is. A boob is fat, and so it's going to hang and be like more pear-shaped. So I don't think it's actually a breast, but I've seen some crazy things in my career, so you never know.
I mean, it feels like a lipoma. It's very mobile, it moves around well, but I mean, I never really know until I go in and remove it.
I think this is a lipoma, but it does sort of come to a point where a nipple would be, and I've seen cysts do that before, so maybe this is a cyst. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see.
I want it gone.
Okay.
It's been a long time.
So let's see if we can do it.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
John's side boob is out. We will, of course, though, send this to pathology to make sure it is nothing to worry about, but he is now boobless.
Here is your lipoma.
Wow.
That was your jiggle right there.
Wow.
You want to hold it?
No.
I didn't think so. But there you go.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're so welcome. I adore you. Oh, you're so cute.
It's been a long time.
It's gone. It's gone. It's done. Guess what? Goodbye.
I got a little emotional because I usually keep a lot of that close to my chest. I try not to show my feelings, but this was just a long time coming. So much.
You're awesome. You're amazing.
I am. So are you.
No,
you deserve all the credit. I was just saying there was no pain, it was painless.
Yes, but to have somebody like wonderful like you that has such good energy to come into our office, it's always a good thing.
Yeah.
You make me cry, man.
When you're embarrassed about some kind of growth or some kind of skin condition you have, it's easy to make jokes because that oftentimes takes the pressure off. And John's a prime example of this. And for somebody to sort of really put down their armor and you see how much this has deeply affected them right after you remove it, it makes you feel good.
My name is Noelle Breckenridge. I'm 29 years old. I began stretching my ears when I was 15 years old. I was definitely drawn to stretching my ears. Not a whole lot of people were doing it, so it was definitely a unique thing that set people apart. When I first started, my ears were already pierced, so I started with jewelry that was just a little bit bigger. As I needed larger sizes, I got more creative and I would use things around the house, like drinking straws, pen caps, marker caps. At their largest, I stretched my ears to over an inch. My ears are stretched enough that I can get my fingers through them. I enjoyed it when I was younger, but I've definitely outgrown the stretched ears.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
What are you here for? You look too cute. I don't even see anything going on with you.
I want my earlobes repaired because I had them stretched for a long time, and this is as far as they've shrunk.
I love the color of your hair.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, yours were stretched a significant amount. What I look at is see how much earlobe you have left that is salvageable. You know, sometimes it thins it out a little bit.
I know people know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. They really expect me or travel from really far for me to pop their pimples, but I'm pretty darn good at repairing earlobes too. I really like that I can be a part of changing people's lives for the better when they've maybe made a decision in the past that they now regret.
So what you have to do in order to really repair an earlobe that's been stretched is the only way you can get the skin to get back together is to refresh the wound edges. Because then it like sort of it becomes like glue, then you can stick it together. But of course you also want to do that and still make it look like an earlobe, you know, that shape. So that's what we're gonna try to do. We're gonna try to probably try to hide the scar line right along the edge of our ear here. So hold this for me. So what I'm trying to do is it's probably gonna be something like that.
Okay. I am nervous about what's really possible. Hopefully my earlobes will look normal again.
All right, let's do that, okay?
Sweet.
It's a tricky procedure to correct stretched earlobes like Noelle's because it's not just a straight side-to-side closure. This is a 3D sort of thing. It's not just a flat surface. You have an earlobe that has a lot of contours and turns to it. I like doing earlobe repair in particular because it's kind of like you have to fit puzzle pieces together, like it's Jenga or Tetris or something, and it really uses your creativity as a surgeon.
Oh, that's crazy.
I purposely hide the stitch right here because if you put a stitch here, it oftentimes will get a little bump. I'm really, really happy with them. They look legit.
Yay! Thank you so much.
No, of course. That was fun.
Yeah.
It was really nice to meet you too. You're lovely.
To see my earlobes new again, I think that it's inspiring. Now I can wear my hair up, so it's nice to be able to leave with a happy ending for my ears and for me.
No one will know that you have them. Only you.
Yay! I'm really excited that I have normal earlobes again.